Microevolution also results from mutation. We can have a perfectly normal phenotype. Everybody looks pretty much the same. And there might be a mutation that causes darker coloration. This arose as a mutation from a population that lacked this particular allele. And this may also explain why your brother is so weird. He's a mutant, okay? So point mutations, as we've seen, can cause effects on phenotypes, and they can have big, profound effects like sickle cell anemia. We can also get gene duplications. This is something I haven't shown yet. We now have the process of crossovers, which you were not familiar with when I went through all the different kinds of mutations a couple of weeks ago. But sometimes when you have a crossover and recombination, when dad and mom are holding hands one last time before meiosis, maybe it's a kind of weird relationship where, you know, dad and mom, and it gets all, and so when they separate, oh, this one's got both dad and mom's genes on the same chromosome, and this one's missing them entirely. Okay, so a whole segment of DNA gets transferred from one partner to the other. This is called an unequal crossover. And unequal crossovers turn out to be actually quite important in evolution because you're bringing like in a whole bunch more gene product by doubling certain loci. So for example, here is an extraordinary gene called SRGAP2, exciting name, which is on a mammalian chromosome, okay? And in non-human mammals, there's just one copy, okay? But something on the way to humans, along our ancestry, going from small little monkey-like things through apes to people, there has been repeated gene duplication so that A, B, A, B, C, and D, these are all replicates of the same gene. So there's four copies on this chromosome, whereas our ancestors only had one. Now, this is really quite remarkable because having four copies of this, this is a gene that influences the connections in our brains. And as I'll go over much later in the course, what's truly our characteristic compared to any other species is the enormous size of our brains. And from a proximate mechanistic scale, what seems to produce this has been this gene duplication in our lineage, so that we now have more gene product that allows our neurons to make many more connections. So there's many more spines coming off of our nerve cells connecting to many more other brain cells, so we can make the connection. We can have complex thoughts. And that's the result of gene duplications. So, ultimately, novel genetic variation is generated through mutation. That's where all new gene forms come from. And our genome, 3 billion haploid base pairs, 6 billion base pairs, is very, very long. And even though DNA replication is extremely accurate, it's not perfect. So on average, each one of us has one or two mutant alleles that were not present in either of our parent. So we are obtaining still new mutations that we will then likely pass on to our own offspring. Now, if we look at this in the terms we've had before of a gene pool, we might have these two alleles in a population, the red and the blue, but then there's a mutation. And if for some reason this mutation might have some benefits, which I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit, but this could become more common. But every generation, there are new alleles appearing from this process of genetic mutation.